Hoi, en welkom. Welkom to a new episode of Inno Update. My name is Maarten Kors en Inno Update is all about corporate innovation. And today's topic is a topic from Tendai Wiki. It's called Innovation Accounting. How do you do the accounting of innovation? And Tendai has spoken a lot of it. He's written books about it. So let me first start off with all the topics you have within corporate innovation. The trends, portfolio, the culture, the teams. And if you look at the innovation accounting, it's all about the indicators. So how do you make sure that your strategy, your teams are on the right track? How do you measure that? You can do that, according to Tendai, on three different levels. The first level is the most granular level, the smallest level. It's the innovation practice. It's the level of your corporate startup team. And you can use the lean startup method. So all these teams are trying to build a new kind of product. They go out of the building, talking to people, observing people, measuring it, for example, using pirate metrics. And then afterwards, they can learn from it. They can learn and they can see, are people using my products? Are they happy with it? If not, they can pivot maybe and try to change something new. But if they are happy, they will try to scale it. So this is the most granular level for the innovation teams. If you go one level up, you come at the innovation governance. It's the innovation management level. So the innovation managers, they have to manage a portfolio of these startup teams. But you can apply the same lean startup methodology. So what innovation management is doing is investing in these corporate startups. Then they have to measure the progress of their portfolio of all these different kind of startups. So it's measuring your portfolio. How are they doing? You have to review it, learn from it. And if it's going well, you have to double down on it. So you have to invest double the money and push these great startup teams to a next level. If not, you have to make sure that the startup is going to exit. That's the second level. And the third level of innovation accounting is the global level, the global corporate level of innovation strategy. And that starts, according to Tendai, with the innovation thesis. And this defines the focus of your innovation within your organization. And based on this innovation thesis, you make investment decisions. So what startup or what kind of portfolio do we want for our company? Of course, also this innovation strategy and the decision to invest money needs to be reviewed. And if things go not as well as you are planning, you have to adapt and to iterate your thesis and maybe change your innovation thesis. So the innovation thesis can and must be changed accordingly every quarterly or half year or, well, at least once a year. And if it goes really well, and if startups are making money and the innovation managers are doing really well, then you can scale the thesis. So these are three levels of innovation accounting, and the actual fun thing is that they grip inside each other. So if you do it well, the innovation strategy, make sure that the innovation management is doing well and that your corporate startups team can do a great job. And on all these different levels, if you have the right KPIs in place, the right metrics, you have an organization which can clearly do innovation accounting in the right way. So what are my thoughts about this? I really like this approach, but it's tough. It's hard to develop a good innovation thesis and to have these innovation accounting circles on all these different kind of levels, because you have to convince the management of the company to do it this way. You have to make sure that every innovation corporate startup team is coached in the right way. So it takes some time to build these kind of innovation accounting loops within your organization. But if you have them, it will be very beneficial to get a great scope of the level of maturity of innovation within your company. If you want to know more and learn more about it, I will post a lot of links in the show notes from Tendai Wiki, presentations, books, articles, because there's a lot you can learn from it. And I think it's a great way to get a more mature innovation culture within your company. So if you liked this episode of Inno Update, I hope you'll check out the next week's episode. And in the meantime, keep innovating.